Nakamura and Ciampa still to come. We are joined right now by the Judgment Day.
And at SummerSlam, in just 5 days from now, a member of the Judgment Day in the Devious, Finn Balor, will hope to put 7 years of bitterness behind him by taking down the World Heavyweight Champion, Seth freaking Rollins.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Judgment Day!
Aquí llegaron los malos. Y con eso dicho, all rise for the Judgment Day!
Let's face it, guys. Monday Night Raw doesn't start until we say it does. Because this is our world now. And for anyone who doesn't want to fall in line, we've got no problem putting them on the shelf. Because let's be honest here, who's really gonna stop us, huh? Hey, boys? Who's gonna stop us?
You know what? Let's try to answer that question. Let's run through a short list of the so-called heroes on Monday Night Raw. Kevin Owens? No, we took him out. Sami Zayn? Nah, we left him laying. Seth freaking Rollins? Impossible after the epic beating we gave him last week on Raw. And we all know what mommy did to Liv Morgan. So to answer your question, nobody can stop the Judgment Day. Now, if Sammy and Seth decide to show up tonight, well, Dirty Dom and I will make sure they don't leave this arena whole.
Seth Rollins, you come out here every week, week after week, and you act all insane. You act insane. You see, your idea of insanity is coming out here wearing some stupid clothes, doing a sing and dance, laughing like a clown. That's not insanity. No. Insanity is waking up every day for the last 7 years, looking yourself in the mirror and seeing the scars that you caused, that you inflicted. And those scars remind me of everything that you took from me, the career that you ruined, the career that you spoiled. Seth Rollins at SummerSlam, I can't erase those scars, but I will inflict scars. And those scars are gonna make me feel just a little bit better knowing that every day that you wake up and you look in the mirror, you'll remember the time that Finn Balor beat you for the World Heavyweight Championship.
And at SummerSlam,
some pride to the Mysterio name. But as for any idiot who decides to try and get in our way, well, I advise them to take a little page out of Raquel Rodriguez's book, and that is run and hide. Because otherwise, they're going to have to learn to enjoy their time in rehab, just like Liv and Kevin Owens. Because...
I think Ms. Rodriguez would beg to differ. Raquel Rodriguez, who still believes that had it not been for Rhea Ripley, she and Liv Morgan would be WWE Women's Tag Team Champions. And Rodriguez is making a beeline for Rhea.
With an injured knee, because of the attack by Rhea Ripley, Raquel Rodriguez is taking the fight to the Eradicator.
Rodriguez certainly holding her own right now.
Two absolute powerhouses. Raquel Rodriguez.
There aren't too many women who can stand toe-to-toe with Rhea Ripley, but Raquel certainly fits that description. Rhea sent to the outside. Rodriguez holding the ring.
The world champion's feeling the wrath of Raquel Rodriguez.
Rodriguez now just woman-handling the women's world champion. Oh! Spine first into the ring post.
Raquel Rodriguez, who, as far as we're aware, wasn't medically cleared to compete in any way, still taking the fight to Rhea.
This isn't a sanctioned match, KP. This is a damn fight.
Oh, no!
Rodriguez momentarily distracted by Dominic's Latino heat. And Rhea made Raquel pay. My goodness. Good thing these officials showed up finally. We could be dealing with two forces of nature, but Ripley again attacking the knee of Raquel.